Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are solving equations with x on both sides, our second video on that topic. Let's just start by double checking you can solve simple cases where x is on both sides. Pause the video and check you can get the answers for this. Hopefully you got the following. I got x was 4 when I did it, so do double check you can do that before moving on. Right, what are we going to do in this video? Well, we're going to do things like this. It looks awful like above, but I'm going to say put a bracket in here and then solve it. The bracket means I should multiply both of these things by the distributive law out first. Or you might see me putting a bracket in this side, and it would just mean I'd have to multiply this side by 2 before I get going. Or you may even see me put brackets on both sides and we have to multiply them out and solve in a similar way to here, but just with one extra step at the start. So that's what we're doing in this video. Let's get going. If you feel like you can do this question, do pause the video and have a go. Otherwise, I'll go through in a second. Okay, step one, I'm going to multiply out. I'm going to multiply the x add 2 by 4 by the distributive law. So I'd get 4x add 8 is equal to 2x add 10. Now I want all the x's on the left hand side, so what am I going to do? I'll subtract 2x from both sides, and I'm going to get myself that on the left hand side I have 2x, still I have this add 8 is equal to positive 10, which I'm just going to write as 10. Then I'm going to subtract the 8 from both sides to undo that add 8, and what am I going to get? I'm going to get 2x on the left hand side is equal to 10 subtract 8, which is 2. And lastly, I'll divide both sides by 2, and I'm going to get myself x is equal to 1. Double check it's right. 1 add 2 is 3, 4 times 3 is 12, 2 times 1 is 2, 2 add 10 is 12. Do my smiley face, I've checked it, I can move on. Next one, pause, have a go yourself. So we've got brackets on both sides here, let's multiply out those brackets on our next line of working. We get 4x subtract 8 is equal to 2x add 20. I'm going to get all the x's on the left hand side, so I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides and write my next line of working. On the left hand side I'm going to have myself 2x subtract 8 is equal to positive 20, which I'll just write like that. To undo this subtract 8, I'm going to add 8 to both sides, and I'm going to get myself on the left hand side simply 2x, and on the right hand side 20 add 8 is 28. And my last step is I'm going to divide both sides by 2, and I'm going to get myself that x is equal to 14. Double check before I go on. 14 subtract 2 is 12, 4 times 12 is 48, 14 add 10 is 24, 2 times 24 is 48. Put my smiley face here, I've checked it. Next, pause, have a go at that. Multiplying out as my first step, I'm going to get 6x subtract 6 is equal to 3x subtract 12. I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides, and I wonder if you don't mind me doing two steps in one. I know afterwards I'm going to add 6 to both sides to get rid of that takeaway 6. So if I did it in one go, that's kind of allowed. That will just help me with my working, less steps. So let's be careful. 6x takeaway 3x is 3x. Negative 6 add 6 is nothing, I picked it on purpose so it would disappear. 3x take away 3x, I picked it to disappear. But negative 12 add 6 is negative 6. Now I can divide both sides by 3, and I'm going to get myself that x is therefore equal to negative 6 divided by positive 3. It's a negative answer, 6 divided by 3 is 2. And that actually was a cool way of me having to write less steps. Let's check before we go on. Negative 2 take away 1 is negative 3, 6 multiplied by negative 3 is negative 18. Negative 2 take away another 4 is negative 6, 3 times negative 6 is negative 18. Smiley face goes here because I checked it and got it right. Next one, pause, have a go. So multiplying out here, we'll just notice that the x is in the second term with inside the brackets, and it's a negative x, like a negative 1x. So multiplying out these brackets, and let's write what we get. I get 5x subtract 15 is equal to 2 times 5 is 10. 2 times negative x is negative 2x. Now, I need all the x's on the left hand side, but I've got a negative 2x here. How could I undo that takeaway 2x? Well, I could add 2x to both sides to get rid of it, but I'd have to add 2x here. How could I get rid of that takeaway 15? Well, I could add 15 to both sides as well, and that would get me with just x's on the left and just numbers on the right. So 5x add 2x is 7x. Negative 15 add 15. I purposely picked that add 15 to get rid of the negative 15. 10 add 15 is 25. And negative 2x add 2x, I purposely added 2x to both sides to get rid of that. Now what am I going to do? Well, I'm going to divide both sides by 7 in order to get x on its own, and x is therefore equal to 25 over 7. Now, it's quite hard to check this is accurate, but I suppose we really should. If I put 25 over 7 in here, 25 over 7 subtract 3 over 1. To subtract fractions, I need to make the denominators the same. Let's make this one have a 7 as well. So really, this is 25 over 7 take away 21 over 7, which is 4 over 7. And 5, and there's still a 5 times it, 5 times 4 over 7 is equal to 20 over 7. That's the left hand side. Whew. Let's check if we can do the right hand side now. 5 take away 25 over 7. So 5 take away 25 over 7. I need to make this over 7. So I need to multiply by 7 there and multiply by 7. Really, that's 35 over 7 take away 25 over 7, which is equal to 10 over 7. And don't forget, I've got to times it by 2. At the end, 2 times 10 over 7 is 20 over 7. I got the right answer. That was a hard one to check, but I did check it. But you've got to be super good at your fractions to check ones like that. So go back to your fraction section within the number strand if you can't do that as quick as I can do that. Right, next one. Pause the video and see if you can have a go at this. Now, this is a lot harder because there's an x here on the left hand side, but there are 3 x's here on the right hand side, and there's going to be more x's here because of this. So what we're going to have to do is sort out maybe the right hand side first and collect like terms, etc., before we solve it. So best idea to do is to multiply out that bracket and multiply out that bracket to begin with. So let's have a go at doing that. What would I get on the left? 5x subtract 15 is equal to, leave this stuff alone just for now, 3x add 4. Remember, this thing here means we're going to multiply this bracket by positive 2. So positive 2 multiplied by positive 5 is positive 10. Positive 2 multiplied by negative x is negative 2x. Now we better collect like terms on the right hand side. We've got 3 x's here, take away 2 x's, and we've got positive 4 and positive 10. So let's just tidy up the right hand side before we try and do too much. This is 5x take away 15 is going to equal 3x take away 2x is 1x, which we just write like that. Positive 4 add positive 10 is positive 14. Now let's make sure all the x's are on the left hand side and all the numbers are on the right hand side to solve for x. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to undo that x there, I'm going to subtract x from both sides, and to undo that takeaway 15, I'm actually going to add 15 to both sides. So I'm doing that in one go. Let's see what we get then. 5x take away 1x is 4x. I've purposely added 15 to remove that subtract 15. X take away x, purposely chosen to give you no x's. 14 add 15 is equal to 29. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 4, and I get myself the answer, x is equal to 29 over 4. Now, I'm not going to check that because checking it is probably harder than doing the actual problem we did. So with these ones, I'm afraid, because they're quite complicated, it's better to just take your time and get them right, because checking's pretty hard unless it's a calculator that you're allowed to use. Last example. I want you to pause, have a go yourself, and I'm going to show you the answer for this one. Right, this is tricky. Here's the answer. I'm just going to talk through the steps quickly. Multiplied out the brackets on this side, and this negative here, I thought of it as negative 1, and multiplied that bracket out by times in by negative 1 and got this. I realized after I collected like terms that I had more x's on the right, so I just rewrote the equation the other way round and solved from there. Double check you can get x is -3, but that is a tricky question. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.